The whole house is designed to be green. Everything about it is green, from its foundation to its materials that are used on the exterior, to the kinds of windows it has, to the kind of ventilation it has. I'm Betty Norbeck, and I live at 1618 Muscatine Avenue. This lot became available about 4 years ago. It had previously had a house on it that was so decrepit that the city had to condemn it. Here, right in the middle of town, there was an open lot. Not only was it an open lot, but a lot that was available to sun. And of course, the upper opportunity, I had somebody who was very qualified to build it.
My mother is a very smart woman, so working with her was fun. And we went through a lot of different iterations, and we really talked about how she wanted to use this space. So we came into this project with two big goals. One was energy efficiency, and then the other big goal was aging in place. An accessory dwelling allows you to have a secondary dwelling so that you can increase the density of your lot.
It became possibility that I, at some point when I needed someone that might live close to me, that would be able to help me with things, that I could exchange their services in exchange for a reduced rent for that person who was going to stay there.
When you think about it, if you space your houses pretty far apart, you have to have more road, more sewer, more electrical lines, more water lines, and so it just uses a lot more materials. When you have more density, by adding an accessory dwelling unit, you can serve more people more affordably.
It's completely equipped with washer and dryer and full kitchen. It's a fully equipped living space. It's not just a place to hang your hat.
The most important thing to start off with is looking at the building envelope. What can you do to make that building envelope more efficient? If you take the concept of a cooler is very well insulated, it's very airtight.
It's kind of like if you have a glove or a mitten, you're losing a lot more heat on a glove, but if you have a mitten, you're holding that heat in, so you want a tight home.
Also important to a lot of individuals is the cost of energy over time. And so if you build a structure that's energy efficient, those costs to you are lower, and the impact on the environment over time is less as well.
And we separated the units that serve the home, so you've got a mini split, which is an air-to-air heat pump that serves the main floor and the basement, and then you have a separate system that serves the upstairs, and they're both incredibly efficient.
This system works so well that my entire bill for energy for the entire year was $400. That was all accrued just during the winter months.
So by making a tight envelope, we could then put in these tiny systems to support this small demand, because heating is your number one demand in the home. And then water heating comes after that. We have small water heaters that are sized for the demand, and they're located very close to the use. So the shower is 12 feet away from the water heater, and that is our longest run for our water. If you have three people in your home, you could be saving $150 a year just in hot water heating costs by switching out to a low flow shower head.
Your wall structure, your windows, not only what windows you put in, but how many you put in.
So if you reduce before you produce, and if you tie together efficiency with the solar, you're going to make those energy dollars stretch further, and you're going to make that solar a more important part of the carbon solution, the climate action solution. So one of the tricky things about this house is it is surrounded by trees, and we also wanted solar power. So when I looked at having a single story home, there was really nowhere to put the solar panels where they wouldn't be shaded a substantial portion of the year. So by looking at a second story accessory dwelling, we were able to raise those panels up high enough so that they get sun exposure all year.
It's very low impact on the environment. We get that energy free from the sun, and that converts into energy in a long term. Once your initial costs are offset, then that's basically free energy.
During the summer, we are currently giving American Energy more kilowatts than they're giving us.
This home is designed to perform 84% better than your average new code compliant home. And so what that means is that for 6 to 8 months a year, she pays $8.59 a month.
We incorporated as many green, sustainable, energy efficient features that we could possibly imagine.
This home is a LEED Platinum home, and LEED stands for Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design, and there's only 2 LEED Platinum homes in the state of Iowa.
People should realize that anything they do that makes your house more green is a good idea. And sometimes you have to make decisions about which ones you can afford and which ones you think are a good trade-off in terms of what it's going to cost you.
Energy efficiency is very important. The energy resources that we have available to us now may not be there in the future.
Energy efficiency is something almost anyone can apply to their home. There are very few homes that don't have opportunities to improve their efficiency. And anyone can take part in reducing their energy bills as well as being a part of climate action.